To go to your ontological editor or the brain, go to your left side panel and click on the B button. Here you'll see the ontological editor is split in three sections: domain, which store all information about the nodes, relationship, which store information about connections, and UDMs, which stand for user-defined models. In the node section, you can create new node subclasses under any of the five core classes: entity, individual, event, location, and item. And you can customize the properties you want to capture for each subclass you'll create. For instance, let's create a company node subclass under the entity class. We start by clicking the plus button. We give our subclass a name, and we can select an icon. If we don't select any icon, the system will use the node subclass name to overlay on the nodes. Next, we can customize the node attribute. For instance, we could create a categories of properties called overview to store basic information about the company type and sector of activity. To add a new property to a node class, go to the property panel and click add a property. Give your property a name, in this case overview, and select the type of properties you want. Here, because it's going to be a categories of attribute, we'll select object. If you want to find out more about data type, check out our video on the topic. Having selected object, I can then create sub properties for that particular object. So here I'll add a properties for company type. In this case, we'll use a set of values for this particular field. So I can set the values here. And now this list of values will be available on the company scorecard. We can also create another attribute by navigating back to overview and click add another property. And here we'll create a property for sector. Here we leave the string as a basic field, allowing us to enter whatever values we want. Once we're happy with our properties, we can save them to the system. Having set up our information requirement, let's see how this looks like in the workbench and add-on. If we go to our website and re-knowledge the page, we can now add our company as a company node in the system. Here I click the plus button, go to entity, because company is a subclass of entity. Here are all the various subclasses I've already created, among them the company we've just created. And when I click on it, I can see the two properties I've created. So here is the company type, which has a set values, which we set earlier. And here is an open field. I can just type whatever values I see fit. So this is a way you can customize your node scorecard to capture the information you're interested in. And the same goes for the analytical workbench. So here on the workbench, I can also create a new node, company, and let's create one for our investor, entrepreneur first. And again, we have exactly the same information structure that we defined earlier.